Hey everyone, welcome to FluentCon and thanks for being here. I am Aditya, a senior year CSE undergrad from India, and I worked with OpenTelemetry a couple of months ago as part of the LFX mentorship program, where I created the FluentBit exporter for OpenTelemetry, which is one of the few things that I will be talking about today. So the goal of this presentation is to give you a brief overview of OpenTelemetry and how you can use FluentBit along with OpenTelemetry to export your telemetry data from your application to the backend of your choice. I will also be giving you a brief demo of an example application that I had worked on for an experimental use case that allowed users to use FluentBit to export not only logs but also trace data from your from the application to the OpenTelemetry collector. So before we start talking about OpenTelemetry itself, I think it is important to understand what observability is and what are the few pain points OpenTelemetry is trying to address. So observability is basically a property of your system or application that allows you to determine what's going on in your system, and you do this by collecting data from the system. And these data are mainly of three types: logs, metrics, and traces. Logs are timestamped records that denote the events that occurred in your system. Traces basically trace the request flow through your system, and metrics are numerical representation of the health of your system. So once you get all these data, you need to correlate them so that you can get rich insights into your system. We need to do all this because systems now are more complex than they used to be because of the distributed nature of the services that we design, and with the adoption of microservices, it has become difficult to find out what's wrong when something breaks. So if we implement observability correctly, it becomes way easier to find out what's wrong and fix it. So OpenTelemetry itself is a merger between two projects called OpenSenses and OpenTracing. OpenSenses and OpenTracing both were projects that gave a standard to allow you to integrate distributed tracing into your project. OpenTracing just provided to you with a tracing API, while OpenSenses had a standard for both traces and metrics. So the two projects understood that observability is a key aspect in modern software systems and decided to merge to create a single set of APIs, SDKs, toolings, and integrations so that users would not have to choose between the two projects and could easily create and manage their telemetry data. OpenTelemetry is also vendor neutral and is currently, if I'm not wrong, the second most contributed to projects behind Kubernetes itself, and it has contributors from over 40 different companies, and this ensures that no company has a say in the direction which the project takes. So let's take a look at the components of OpenTelemetry. So the main components are the specification, the OpenTelemetry collector, and instrumentation libraries. OpenTelemetry itself has a really pluggable architecture, so you can create your own components if you really need to, and you can add extensions or modify the existing ones if you need to. So the API allows you to instrument your applications, libraries, and frameworks, and the SDK implements those APIs. Semantic conventions are basically naming conventions for traces, attributes, etc. to ensure consistency across the various language implementations. The OpenTelemetry collector is a component that receives telemetry data, processes it, and exports it to the backend of your choice. So the request data flow usually looks something like this. So we have an application in which we use the OpenTelemetry API to instrument our application, which is implemented by the SDK, and the instrumentation that is generated is exported using the exporters. Now the exported telemetry is sent to the OpenTelemetry collector, where we usually collect the data from various applications and we have it in a single place. The collector enriches this data and passes it through various processors and then sends it to the exporter to send it to various backends. So let's have a look at the OpenTelemetry collector. The collector is by far one of the most important components of OpenTelemetry because it allows you to receive, process, and export telemetry data. So it does this by using config files to define the behavior, and a major advantage of this is that it allows you to decouple sampling, queuing, and retry logic from your application code itself. And by providing a simple config file, you don't have to change your application code every time when you need to make some changes in the collector. So the OpenTelemetry collector has units called pipelines that are mainly of three types based on the data that they deal with. So these are traces, metrics, and logs. So the basic logic of the collector is it will take telemetry data from the various receivers, it will pass them to the processors, and the process, after it has been processed, it will send it to the exporters that will export it to various backends. So the cool thing about this is that OpenTelemetry converts all the data to an internal data format so that you can convert it into whatever backend you want. So let's say I have traces coming in from the OTLP protocol. I will be able to convert this into an internal format, and then I can convert it into the format that Jaeger requires or the format that Zipkin requires. So by doing this, I can not only send the telemetry data to one backend, but as many backends that I want to. So along with these three components, the collector also has additional extensions that are not part of the core collector but provide additional functionality. Example, the health extension, which responds to health messages. We can also have a look at the config file. So we first define all the components that we have. So we have various receivers, exporters, and processors, also extensions, and then we define the pipelines that we want. So here we can see that for the traces pipeline, I am receiving the telemetry data using the OTLP protocol. I am passing it to the batch processor, and from the batch processor I am sending it to the login and Jaeger exporters. So the login exporter will log the data to the console, while the Jaeger exporter will export it to the Jaeger backend. Similarly for metrics, we do the same thing, but instead of sending it to Jaeger, because Jaeger does not support metrics, we use Prometheus. So the metrics are sent to a Prometheus backend. So you might be wondering what FluentBit has to do with all this. And the approach that OpenTelemetry has taken with logs is different than that it has taken with traces and metrics. So for traces and metrics, OpenTelemetry has defined a new API and language implementation for both of those. But for logs, it makes use of third-party agents to collect and process logs, and OpenTelemetry only focuses on enriching the data. So if you are already using a different log model, what OpenTelemetry does is it takes all the log data and converts it into its recommended format based on the log data model that has been defined in the specifications repo. And from there we can export it to any backend that we want to. So usually what we do is we use the OpenTelemetry API for metrics and traces and use a third party agent like FluentBit to collect the logs and send it to the collector. So now I want to talk about how you deploy a OpenTelemetry collector and how you can use FluentBit to export traces as well as logs. So we can see here in this diagram that we generally have an application that has an OpenTelemetry library embedded in it, which sends the instrumentation data to an OpenTelemetry collector that is deployed as an agent, from where it is sent to the backends of your choice or an OpenTelemetry collector. So the logic behind this is that OpenTelemetry collector can be deployed as an agent or a standalone service. So typically when you deploy it as an agent, you deploy it as close to your application so that like I said before, you don't have to worry about things like retry logic or queuing or sampling logic, and you can just edit the config file if you wanted to change something. And while you in case you want to deploy it as a service, you can also do that, so that this is usually deployed on a different machine that does not have resource constraints, so it can collect data from multiple hosts, and you can have all your telemetry data in a single place. So now that we understand this, we can imagine a scenario in which we are not generating a lot of trace data and we already have deployed a FluentBit or a FluentD agent along with the application, because you anyways need to deploy it to collect logs since OpenTelemetry does not do that. So in this case, if you don't want to deploy the OpenTelemetry collector, what you can do is you can use a FluentBit exporter which you can install directly inside your application that will send data to the OpenTelemetry collector using the FluentBit service, so thereby eliminating the need for deploying an additional collector agent. So that's the application that I had worked on, and we do this by making use of the Fluent Forward plugins, input and output plugins, which follow the FluentD Forward protocol. And this protocol defines the format in which you send data to it. And if you send data as a message back array in this specific format, it will recognize it and parse it and send it to the output plugins that you have used. So what we do is we are using FluentD or FluentBit to collect logs as well as traces. So what we will do is we reserve a special tag name called data.span to denote that okay, this is a span, so parse it accordingly. And when we do this, we effectively can tell the OpenTelemetry collector that logs need to be routed to the logs pipeline and the spans need to be routed to the traces pipeline. So let's take a look at how the data flow looks like. So we have an application and we have installed our Fluent Forward exporter inside. This Fluent Forward exporter will send the telemetry data, that is traces, to the FluentBit instance that can also be reading logs from any file or any input plugin. And this FluentBit instance will forward the data that it receives to the collector. On the collector side, we have the Fluent Forward receiver running, which sees the tag of the span, and if it sees that the tag is data.span, it will tell the collector that okay, this is a span, and it passes it on to the traces pipeline, and if it is not, then it routes it to a logs pipeline. So once you do this, the processes that you had defined in the collector config will take place in that order, and it will be sent to the exporter where it can be exported to Jaeger or whatever exporters that you had configured. With this out of the way, I think we can take a look at a demo application. So let's first take a look at the Fluent config file. So this input plugin basically reads the log files, and this is the forward plugin that I was talking about, which listens on this port for trace data. So our exporter that we had configured in our application will send the traces to this port. And we can also see that there's an output plugin that logs data to the console, and one that uses the forward plugin to send the data to the OpenTelemetry collector, where the Fluent Forward receiver is listening for data using the Fluent Forward protocol. So now we can look at the config for the OpenTelemetry collector, and here we have defined the receivers, the processors, and the exporters. And for the pipelines, we say that both the traces and the logs pipelines will make use of the same receiver and pass the data to the batch processor, from which it will be exported to the Jaeger backend or log to the console if it is a log. So with this done, we can start the collector and take a look at the application that we had written. So this application basically first initializes a trace provider. A trace provider is basically a component that gives you access to a tracer And tracers are responsible for creating spans. So we need to initialize a trace provider first, which is globally set. And once we do that, we can access tracers based from that. So we create a tracer, and using that tracer, we create a span and add an event to it. And let's say we had an service that this particular service was calling. So we simulate that using a sub operation, which is just a function call. So inside that function, we again create a tracer, and using that tracer, we start a span, which will be a sub span of the original parent. So we can start the FluentBit service, and we can already see that the FluentBit instance has read the app log file and forwarded the data to the collector, which we can verify in the collector, which shows that okay, I got a log message from some application. Now if I run our example application, sorry about that. Yeah, so we can see that Fluent bit receives a message back array and has the tag data.span. So it will signify to the fluent forward receiver on the collector side that okay, this is a span, and we can verify that in the collector logs, and it shows that okay, I am receiving two spans here. So we can also open up Jaeger in our local host and find traces, and like I said, we can find the spans here. So this is the message that we had added on the span as an event, and this is a subspan where we had also added an event. So that's a demo for me, and I believe that's the end of my time. You can also scan this QR code to see the slides or visit the URL. So thanks for your time, and that will be it from my side.